Okay, this is the notes page for obtaining information from a graph, and it's a little bit of review, which is just a little extra information. So we've talked about how to find the interval of x values when f of x is greater than 0 or when f of x is less than 0, and we talked about how that involves drawing a horizontal line, the x-axis, y equals 0, and if it's above it, f of x is greater than 0. If it's below, f of x is less than 0, but we need to pull the x values off. Well, we're going to do the same thing, except now we're going to change from greater than 0 to greater than or equal or less than to some other number. And the directions say write the solutions. Well, in the other one it said write the interval. Well, in this case, solutions also means write the x values. The solutions are the x values. The inputs are the solutions, the x values in interval notation. So all of our answers are going to be x values in interval notation. And if it's in interval notation, remember it's smallest number to largest number always. Okay, so number one, find the solutions where f of x is greater than negative 3. That means find the x values that are making the y values greater than negative 3. So what you want to do is you want to draw a horizontal line, y equals negative 3. Okay, and so I'll do that with this marker. So here's negative 3, and here is the horizontal line. And then you're going to make note of the intersection, so I'll make open circles here. Okay. And then f of x is greater than negative 3 when the function is above that line. But that's not the answers that you want to be writing down. What you want to be writing down are the x values that are making that happen. So the x value where when x is negative 5, y is negative 3. So that's an ordered pair right there. Okay, so when x equals negative 5, y is negative 3, but we don't want it to equal negative 3. We want it to be greater than. So we need to leave that hole open. So when x is from negative 5, and then all of these x values, negative 5, negative 4, negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, and then here, so we're transferring these values up. So here that looks like to me somewhere between 1 and 2, a little bit more than a half, so I'll just say 1.6. So that's the interval of x values from negative 5 to 1.6 that make this function greater than negative 3. Then it happens again right here, this intersection, and we have to carry it up to the x-axis. Just looks a little bit more than 6, so union 6.1. And then all of these x values, it's going to keep going, so to infinity. These are x values here and here. Negative 5 to 1.6. Union 6.1 to infinity, and I have parentheses on everything because we're not saying that we're not including the negative 5 and the 1.6. These are open boundaries. So this answer too, number 2, f of x is greater than or equal to negative 3 is still going to be these same values. It's just now we get to, because of the equal to, we get to include the negative 5 and the 1.6 and the 6.1. But we can't include infinity. So that's number 2. All right, now moving to number 3, we want all the x values, the solutions, the x values that are going to make the y values less than negative 3. So we've already drawn the line y equals negative 3, but now the x values that are, the y values that are less than or equal to negative 3 would include here and then everything here. So in interval notation, we have to start from the left. That would be negative infinity to, again, negative 5. And I shouldn't have colored that in yet because we want it to be less than negative 3. Union parentheses 1.6 comma 6.1. And everything is in parentheses because we can't include the things that are making it equal to negative 3. Here's where it equals negative 3. Here's where it equals negative 3. Here's where it equals negative 3. So number 4, that's just going to change to where we get to include where it equals negative 3, negative 5, 1.6, and 6.1. So we'll change those to brackets, but never put a bracket on the infinity, negative infinity or positive infinity. Okay, so that's the change. Is now we might have to draw a horizontal line other than 0. Okay, so the second thing on this page here it says identify the zeros. All right, what are the zeros of a function? The zeros of a function, very important. The zeros of the function are the x values that make this true. When is the function equal to 0? That's why they're called zeros. So the values of x that make the function 0 are the x-intercepts. So another word for zeros of a function are the x-intercepts. The x-intercepts are found where the function crosses the x-axis. They're on the x-axis. So every x-intercept is in the form of some number, comma, 0, because we know this means y. So we're just looking for the zeros of the function. And I put this here because this is what WebAssign says sometimes. It says writing them as ordered pairs. That means like that, with an x value and a y value, not just the x value, in order from smallest x value to largest x value. So WebAssign does that so it can computer grade your answers. So the zeros are the x-intercepts. So there's one right here, and there's one right here, and there's one right here. So in order of smallest x value to largest x value written as an ordered pair, that would be negative 4, 0, right there, and then 0, 0, right there, and then 7, 0. So those are the zeros of the function, otherwise known as x-intercepts. All right, and then the final thing is write the solutions to the following inequalities using interval notation. So this one's just like number 1. We want to find the x values, solutions, in interval notation, always. That make f of x greater than 2, f of x greater than or equal to 2, f of x less than 2, f of x less than or equal to 2. So that's all done by drawing the horizontal line y equals 2. Okay, so y equals 2 is right here. Here's 1, here's 2, so here's y equals 2. Here's the horizontal line. And so then we want to transfer these values where they intersect down to the x-axis. Okay, so that looks like negative 1, negative 2, negative 2.5, we'll say, maybe a little off, but that's close enough. And then 1, so this would be 1.5. Okay, so for f of x is greater than 2, we're looking for where is the function greater than 2, and that would be all of these values right here, all these x values here, or here, but not in here. So the x values that make f of x greater than 0 would be negative infinity to negative 2.5 parentheses union parentheses 1.5 comma infinity. And then f of x is greater than or equal to 2. All you have to do is change. This is the order pair negative 2.52. This is the order pair 1.52. So when x is negative 2.5, y is 2, so we'll change that to a bracket, and 1.5 to a bracket. Number 3, where is f of x less than 2? Well, those solutions, those are x values that make this happen, and the x values that make that happen are right here. So we already figured out the x value, so number 3 would be parentheses negative 2.5 comma 1.5 parentheses, because we don't get to include where they make it equal to. And number 4, f of x is less than or equal to 2, you get to include the values that make it equal to. So that's it for notes page for obtaining information from a graph.